Kevin Schwantz, you got to ride your old GP bike at Indy. Now, we actually got emails, people saying, did you get any footage of Kevin on the bike at Indy? Did you get any footage? And we weren't even there. Dorna didn't invite us. Darn guys. But you got to ride your GP bike, and you were just telling us about the carbon brakes. Now, you got to go through that whole thing again there.
Well, original rotors back then, carbon in its developing stages, would have cracks on the outer surface. And the guys always told me nothing to be concerned about. But as it sat for 15 or 16 years, getting back on it, trying to get that heat back in those brakes, every time I squeezed the brakes, there was always that, I guess, that thought in the back of my mind that rotors might be exploding or breaking or whatever. So every time I squeezed them, I was like, oh, good, they worked again. And it was funny because I got to do three laps. The tires warmed up pretty quick. The power of the bike to me is still awesome. How light it is, how well it just does everything. Change direction, accelerate. Trying to figure out how to wheelie one obviously was a bit of an art back in the day, but I rode them so often that it really didn't matter. Getting back on one now, as soon as it started to wheelie, I could not get my wrist back over and get the throttle shut quick enough. So the best wheelie I did all weekend was coming in pit lane as I was cooling off, and I was coming in thinking, oh, it's, you know, I really got a good wheelie, I could carry this a bit further. And as I'm thinking that, I'm remembering the brakes have worked every time so far, and I just see a mass of people, and I can just picture me and my 1993 RGV 500 careening off in this crowd of people with no brakes going, get out of the way. So it was awesome to ride it in Indianapolis. Motor Speedway was a treat.
Now, just for what you're saying, the reason that it's tricky on a 500 is because it can get away from you as quickly as it builds so quickly that you can't roll off fast enough to save it.
Yeah, and the rear brakes, I never really used rear brake. And always felt like I could just get the 500 up there and balance it with a good, you know, good power wheelie. Had enough power. You know, it's just not the case until you get to where you ride them at that level all the time. Brah, 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 you know, you can really keep it in the power band. Because the power band's only about, on a good day, 3,500 RPM. So as it comes up, it feels like it just wants to flip over backwards when it finally does start to wheelie. And at that point, it's, what am I going to hope it does? I don't want to look like Alvaro Bautista at Checo, so, and especially not on that old thing.
And now what, it's back in your living room?
It's actually sitting in Indianapolis Motor Speedway Museum right now. I'm going to leave it there through the end of the year. It's possibly going back to Barber Motorsports Park for a vintage motorcycle weekend that they have coming up there.
But otherwise, it lives in your house in the living room next to the fireplace?
That's where it's been for the past 15 years anyway. 16, actually.
Does it have a glass case over it, or does it sit out open?
No, it sits out in the open. It's got a little platform that it sits up on that lights it from the bottom. You can turn the switch on and turn the lights on. It's got trophy cases, glass-fronted trophy cases beside it that have a bunch of the trophies that I've won in it. So I live in a condo now, so there's no room. So it actually butts heads with my dad's Manx Norton at their house.